गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, टुडे आवर टॉपिक अंडर मेटल्स एंड नॉन मेटल्स इज केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ मेटल्स। एट फर्स्ट केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज, व्हाट आर केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज? व्हेन केमिकल चेंज टेक्स प्लेस दैट इज कॉल्ड केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज। व्हाट एक्चुअली द केमिकल चेंज? व्हेन द मिल्क कन्वर्टेड इनटू कर्ड, बर्निंग ऑफ वुड और बर्निंग ऑफ मैग्नीशियम रिबन, दिस इज द मैग्नीशियम रिबन, व्हेन वी बर्न इट दैट डैजलिंग फ्लेम एंड फॉर्म्स द मैग्नीशियम ऑक्साइड एश लाइक स्ट्रक्चर, दिस इज द केमिकल चेंज। एंड फिजिकल चेंज, जस्ट दिस इज द पेपर एंड आई हैव रैप्ड इन दिस। व्हाट दिस चेंज? दिस इज फिजिकल चेंज, there is no any color change or appearance change, okay, this is just the physical change. So all of you got the chemical change. So chemical properties of metals we have to see. At first, when any metal react with oxygen, that form metal oxides. For example, when copper is reacted with oxygen in the air, that form copper oxide. When aluminium metal react with oxygen in the air, that form aluminium oxide Al2O3. And these metal oxides, as in the exam, their nature, they are acidic in nature or basic in nature? Metal oxides that are basic in nature. Then the next point come here, amphoteric oxides. What are these amphoteric oxides? This is the exception to metal oxide. These amphoteric both, they react with acids also and they react with base also and form salt and water. Just like the example of amphoteric oxides, Al2O3, aluminium oxide, ZnO, zinc oxide, these are called amphoteric oxides. When these amphoteric oxides react with acid, aluminium oxide react with hydrochloric acid, that forms the aluminium chloride and water, the salt and water. And also with base, this aluminium oxide react with base, which base? Sodium hydroxide. The same reason, salt and water, NaAlO2+H2O, this is NaAlO2, this is sodium aluminate. Now the next, metal oxide, whether they are soluble in water or insoluble in water. Maximum metal oxides are insoluble in water. But what the exception? Which metal oxides are soluble in water? That is the sodium oxide and potassium oxide. When sodium oxide reacts with water, that forms sodium hydroxide. And potassium oxide reacts with water, that form potassium hydroxide. These are soluble in water. Which are the soluble metal oxide? Sodium oxide and potassium oxide. Now the questions, what the result came when metal react with O2? Give example. Answer is in the right side. When the metal react with oxygen, that form metal oxides. Example are here, copper react with O2, copper oxide, aluminum react with O2, aluminum oxide, magnesium react with O2, magnesium oxide. Next, write the pH nature of metal oxide. What the metal oxide form? CuOAl2O3. Their pH nature what? Acidic or basic? Basic. Now the next question, amphoteric oxides. What amphoteric oxides? They react with acids also and base also. They are called amphoteric oxide. And what the reason? What they form? Salt and water they form. Just like example given here. Now the next, which are the exceptional metal oxides soluble in water? Maximum metal oxides are insoluble in water. Which are soluble metal oxides? Exceptional. Here, sodium oxide and potassium oxide. These are soluble in water. This is the product. This is the exceptional metal oxide soluble in water. Sodium oxide and potassium oxide. Now the next question. Describe the reactivity of all metals same with O2 in air. Explain. Does all metals react with oxygen in the air similarly? Definitely not. Metals are different and their reactivity with the oxygen in the air, that is also different. That answers we will get in further questions. Why the metals such as potassium and sodium kept immersed in kerosene oil? Sodium, potassium, even lithium also, that always kept immersed in the kerosene oil. We cannot put the sodium and potassium in room temperature or general temperature. What happens? They vigorously react with oxygen in the air and get fired. So we cannot keep them at room temperature, normal temperature. We have to keep them immersed in the kerosene. So these are the highly reactive metal or less reactive metal. Sodium and potassium are highly reactive metal. Then next, why the surface of metals magnesium, aluminium, zinc, lead covered with thin layer of oxide? See the metals magnesium, aluminium, zinc, lead. These metals covered with thin layer of oxide. Why? To prevent further oxidation. To prevent no more oxidation. So they get covered with the metal oxide. Then the next, why silver and gold not reacted with O2? Silver and gold. Generally, in ornaments that are used, that are prepared, costly metals, they are not reacted with O2. There is no any effect, just like iron corrosion or copper oxide form. This not get reacted with O2. Why? Very simple. Silver and gold are less reactive metal. Thank you.